Hi, welcome to the High Time Podcast. This is episode 3 and we'll be talking about coronavirus with my host Jonas Menezes and Chris Andrade.
Hi guys.
Sup.
How are you guys?
Fine.
Long time no see. Long week again, lots of discussions and talks.
So I see that Jonas, you're growing your hair and your beard.
Yeah. Actually, many of them are literally asking me the same question, you know, like, this was the last video or so of us. Everyone's like, Jonas, what happened to your hair? And I'm like, let me grow, I said, want to try for once, you know, like, of course, like, you have to, like, try your own looks.
Yeah.
Like, surprisingly, yeah, even I didn't know, actually, even I had curls, you know.
You look good, though.
I don't think so.
Yeah. At least better than what shit used to look before, dude.
Huh, who's talking big?
Chris! We can finally see you with a new haircut, new beard shape and all.
Yeah. I actually tried cutting my hair on my own for the first time.
Okay.
That didn't work very well, so I had to go to the barbers to cut.
You look good now, decent.
Yeah, thanks.
No,
so you trimmed your beard at home then or you went out somewhere?
No, I got someone to trim it at home.
Hmm.
But normally I trim it on myself at home.
Oh, I actually went out to the barbers to get my hair cut this time.
Okay. Yeah, but how could you do that with the coronavirus and all?
Well, actually, I went out and I, like, you know, I made sure that I'm the first customer over there.
Okay.
Because if you're the first customer over there, the barber didn't, you know,
he didn't serve anyone
before.
Yeah.
So you are more safer if you go first. So I had to, like, get up about 6 o'clock in the morning because I had to be at the barber's by 8.
So
luckily, I was the first.
Nice. So what was your experience going to a barber during coronavirus?
Well, it was kind of risky, but...
Did you have to wear a mask or anything?
Yeah, we had to wear a mask like while entering. Then later they gave us sanitizer and all.
Okay.
The barber asked me to remove the mask if I want, but I said no, I'm not going to remove it.
And what about the beard? Did you have to remove your mask for that?
Yeah, I had to remove my mask for that.
One second. Of course, what a lame question that is. Of course... And he's going to tell the Baba, no Baba, I'm going to trim the beard. Huh?
I mean, you could have done it at home. You never know.
But he clearly mentioned it though. That
I did try trimming it many times at home. But the problem was, I always mess it up and my beard this side becomes longer.
I've
than
had the same experience where, you know, you trim your beard and you think it looks good until you look at the other side of your face where you have one patch here. There's hair all over you except a certain patch and you don't look good after that.
Yeah.
And you're very lucky because you don't have siblings who mock you after looking at you.
So wait, now we're talking about that. What are the cases in Mangal going on, Chris?
It raised a lot starting. Like literally it was like 200 cases and all. And now recently, I guess 2-3 and it has been days any new case has been found in Mangal. Now it's more of the north side, I feel. North Goa has more cases now.
Till we are taking a precaution.
No, you gotta take precautions till this thing ends. It will be about like till next year, I feel.
I think so. Like Russia, it's with the they came out with the
That's
vaccine
what they
like,
say,
almost soon.
And they
say
that India is in talks with Russia to get the vaccine to India, but we don't know how far that is true and how far Russia's vaccine actually works because they haven't released any test results saying. Okay.
They haven't given their test results to WHO.
Yeah.
That's the thing. If they would give the test results there, saying that yes, it does work, then it would be like, you know, acceptable worldwide. So right now in Russia, they are saying it is working. I just checked the news yesterday.
What
they
I
said
actually looked. Recently when I saw the news, actually in India also, like, in India and Dubai, which what I, to contrary what I saw, they have actually on the second phase. Like, you know, they have total 3 phases.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, India and Dubai, they have reached the vaccine with the second phase, but they're still working on the third phase.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And Dubai, with the third phase, actually, they were like trying on different people, like from different citizens, you know, people on the cases. I don't like how it is, but I think so. Like, they were saying, I don't know, Donald Trump, USA, you follow the president.
Who doesn't know Donald Trump?
Some people. Chappari people.
There's some idiots who don't
know
Donald Trump.
No, because Donald Trump tweets shit and that shit is talking about.
Talking about Donald Trump, he won a Nobel Prize, right?
Yeah, for the peace.
Peace between Israel and UAE.
Yeah, that's a bit disturbing to hear.
Mm.
Anyway, speaking of the coronavirus vaccine, did you guys know that Wuhan is the epicenter and the outbreak of the virus is actually free from coronavirus?
Yes.
That's one thing, you know, people don't understand. How it is possible? The case actually started from Wuhan.
Yeah,
literally over there. And there are literally no cases now.
But yeah, I think what their government...
I'm not saying like no cases, like there are...
Yeah, but I think what happened was once their authorities realized that, oh my, there are cases, I think they took precautions.
Yeah, right.
Precautions, and because of that, I think the cases reduced and it completely vanished from there. If you understand.
I don't
that kind
that.
Of feels a bit complicated, but
actually I should give a big shout out to Italy.
Yeah,
like, you know, they were actually the first country who had a big impact
outside of China. Yeah,
and but plus you have to say, like, the people actually really didn't care, you know, about it, the case, like, roaming here and there.
Still, the same thing is still going on in USA right now.
Yeah,
USA,
people,
like,
people are like, oh, this is going to be the end of the world, so why not die?
Yeah, yeah.
Just let's enjoy our death. They literally said this in some interviews.
No,
to be honest, it's pretty annoying when you hear that.
I mean, you can't do anything about it. We are doing what we can do.
Mm.
You know, like, talking about CLI, especially about the world cases total are 28.5 million. And the death rate is 9,016K. You can imagine.
Something around that.
So many people died.
Yeah.
But I'm surprised, you know, we got a good recovery status. It's 19.2 million. And but talking about the world, talk about our country first.
Yeah, I know.
Which is 4.66 million total cases average.
Mm-hmm.
And the recovery cases for that is 3.62 million.
Mm-hmm.
And death cases are 77,472.
Mm.
You can imagine.
That's
and
very specific.
Like, and plus, like, you know, I recently checked, I messaged Joel, 1,000 plus cases have increased.
Today,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
Anyway, speaking, we spoke of the world, we spoke of India. Let's go to a personal level. How has coronavirus impacted you, Chris, on a personal level?
On a personal level, it's a good question. Actually, there's nothing much that changed in my life, okay? It's like, the only thing is, now, I had some videos which I was supposed to be shooting.
Okay.
Like, I wanted to do a hide and seek challenge, I told you about this.
Yeah.
That I wanted to bring a bunch of people, like all my friends, take them to a location, like sort of like how Mr. Beast does. And you hide wherever you want. The last person to be found gets a prize. So the thing is, like, I was ready for this. I had people ready for this. But then, like, somewhere around my board exams, that time COVID came here in Goa. Coronavirus reached here.
That we were actually lucky just one day.
Yeah, actually, it was like our last paper, psychology, right?
Yeah.
That was our last paper. We finished our last paper and then rest all papers after that got postponed. Luckily, we didn't have anything at that time.
Yeah, you
somebody
guys
else said something.
You guys were very lucky. Unfortunately, for me and people who were part of the CBSE and Delhi board, our papers got postponed by about a month. And the thing is with me is, first of all, I coronavirus impacted me with meeting all of my friends. Luckily, I can meet you guys right now, but many of my friends, we used to either go to play football or we would go out, have a good time. Like, many a times we three have gone out.
Yeah.
So I think all of that stopped, and that was really devastating.
Mm-hmm.
But what was more devastating was my exam.
Mm-hmm.
The most important exam of my life up till now, my board exam, which I needed to answer and get a good score in to get into a good college of my choice. I couldn't answer. I mean, I could answer most of them, it's just the final paper that I couldn't answer because of coronavirus. And I remember the day my exam got postponed. So I was eagerly waiting for 2 days. 2 days later was my exam, and I was really waiting because I had been studying since Jan. December.
And this guy made so many plans to be ready.
Yeah, and I had been studying really hard since December. So 4 months of just studying hard and not doing anything else, and I really needed that break after the exams to cool down, I think, and it was 2 days for my last exam, and Chief Minister Mr. Pramod Sawant,
who is by the way COVID-19 positive right now.
Yes, who said
Bhupache Karasna,
and now he's in COVID. I don't know what he's doing. Who cares? So 2 days, and then he announced a lockdown, and I couldn't answer my exams. So and then I waited for 2 months, I think. And then CBSE finally released a thing, a statement saying that we will release your results on based on your internals. Hey Jonas, how's it on you? How's coronavirus affecting you on a personal level?
For me, I don't know much what to say. Because I mean, one thing is that, that's true fact, like, you know, we can't get to go out.
Yeah.
And plus then the same with the college, which actually I felt like the government actually had to not teach anyone, right? And they had to keep a 0 year for us. And
I think going for a 0 year would be better. Even though I know many people would complain we would be missing a year or so, but if you look
but
at
actually,
it,
zero
if you look at it, we are starting our college in September, and we have what, 6-5 months for it to end.
Yeah.
And they've pushed back that deadline now, which I mean, it doesn't make sense, because you are putting so much of pressure on the students, because you have to complete the portion, go through exams, and you've got such a limited time. And if you miss that deadline, then you don't know what the consequences are or what the government could do to you.
Hmm.
I feel also like, you know, like teaching, like I feel, I won't say like it's not bad, online classes, they're actually good.
Yeah.
But for those actually the students like who can't cope up, like literally, and the you know, our country, like everyone doesn't have the facilities, right? And everyone doesn't have Wi-Fi their place.
Yeah,
and plus you don't some of them like the got network and what.
Mm.
You miss an important part, you know, missing one important part.
I think
part
the most
like
important part of not being able to go to college is the personal touch and getting to meet your new and old classmates and making connections there, if you know what I mean.
You know, one thing which I miss actually of our group, at least, we don't get to see Zane anymore.
Yeah.
Zane's not been, we didn't see Zane for about 2-3 months, I think.
Yeah.
So now I'm probably thinking, who is Zane?
Zane's the fourth guy in our podcast.
He's the fourth guy. But
he's kind of like a guest star. He's a bit
this shy person. Like he doesn't like to come in front of the camera and all. So you'll see him sometime in the video, don't worry.
Yeah, you must have seen him in my vlogs, if any of y'all are, you know, still watching my channel.
Wait, I just want to give a shout out to a person. His name is Vanik Glover.
Vanik, yes.
Go check out his music, it's really good, awesome. And now he's coming to the latest song, I Know. I wish I had the audio. I had the audio actually. We're going to play it at the end of the
episode.
Podcast.
Yeah, episode.
So please check it out and subscribe to him.
Yeah, yeah.
So back to the podcast.
Recently on his
he's available on all platforms also. That's the most important.
Yeah. His new song will be available 15th of this month.
15th.
Do go listen on all platforms.
Yeah, I heard the trailer and it's
really
good.
It's good.
I liked it.
What do you feel like? One question I want to ask you all. In your opinion, how do you feel like, did the government take right actions during this time, the pandemic?
To be honest, I don't want to talk too much about the government because it's a political game and all that. But in my personal opinion, I think when Goa was a green state and we didn't have cases that were rising, we might have had one or two, but it wasn't, you know,
it was kind
but
of
see,
look,
it was
one thing
spreading.
One thing before you go, I want to say, you can't blame the government for everything actually. You have to even blame the people.
Yeah.
Yes,
my
but
you know,
I think in this coronavirus situation, the government gets most of the blame, because when Goa was a green state, the government decided to
open
the
borders.
Open borders, yeah. That was the biggest mistake.
And that is what made Goa go back
to red zone.
Not only to red zone, but you know what happens is, once one person gets the case, and since Goa was a green zone, when people came in, people roamed around freely without any mask or anything, and that's what made the cases increase. Or you know, so
the one thing is like the cases first started in Mangor Hill, right?
Yeah.
So the thing was, when we were a green zone, I went around that side, okay? because I had to go to the club and all that.
Yeah.
Side. So when I was passing that side, I saw that there were people standing there, outsiders mainly.
Okay.
No social distancing, no mask.
This was during,
nothing.
This was when the borders were opened or before?
This was like you say, one day before the, you know, borders were opened. And even when the borders were opened, there was no social distancing, nothing. Literally everybody knew that once the borders will be open, like coronavirus may come back to
yeah.
Goa. But like people should have thought at least that, okay, if COVID is going to come back, let's at least maintain social distancing. Let's wear masks for some time. But no, they just wanted to like hang out on their bike with bloody chhapris over there. Okay.
I mean... Yeah, see,
that is a true fact for us.
Like you
that's
said,
right.
Like you said, Jonas, it's a some the people are to be blamed to some extent because when there were cases, we didn't take swift enough action to, you know, lock ourselves up or take precautions, and that's why we are in the situation we are now.
Mm.
And we're talking about that also now. I've met some few people, core people, and even you have seen actually on the news channels, literally everything. That no proper hospitality, you know, people are,
yeah,
I mean, what they are affected.
They don't get proper food and nutrition.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like, even like the I don't know what the nurses, what they are doing. Something, people, some of them complaining in the washroom, like nothing is clean over there.
So to be honest, my father knew one guy who was
COVID.
Admitted in, yeah, who was tested coronavirus positive and was admitted into a hospital. He didn't meet this person, he spoke to him over phone, and this guy was explaining to my father how the coronavirus hospital worked.
Mm.
And that guy said that they don't, the doctors, the nurses, no one cares about you.
Yeah, right.
And when you have coronavirus, that hospital is a mad hospital. Because everyone is running around, no matter, it may be a doctor, maybe a nurse, it may be even a patient. The patient is allowed to walk around in the halls free.
Okay.
That was the most disturbing fact for me because you're a patient. Suppose I know a patient, you can visit that patient. You are allowed to visit a patient at least once, I think. If you visit a patient, how can you have other patients walking around freely?
Yeah.
Isn't that going to spread coronavirus?
That's correct.
I don't know. My basically, I some parts, what the government did, I feel like they have not taken right actions like at all.
Mm.
Which
I
feel like they have to improve in that.
I think.
But in my view, they made a bad decision. I feel like they're going to reopen schools for the 9th and 12th, okay? They said. So I don't know when, basically, so November, September, something there.
Mm.
Yeah,
November,
I think they've given
beginning.
A date of November 21st or
something. Yeah,
like
right.
Something,
that,
something
way.
Like that.
Which
know.
I feel like, see, okay, then something. They're going to call the students, like, batch wise. But okay, you're calling the students in batch wise. What if that one person is affected, okay? And in case you're calling batches, of course, after school later, like, when the teacher goes out, students will come in contact with it, right?
Yeah. See, actually, they are children, 9 to 12th, okay? Like, even when we were in 9th standard, we did not take things that seriously, right? Like, now...
But, see, look, now this...
So how will they
have
take
had the your ninth standard? You have that brains like the knowledge,
yeah,
like,
but,
you know,
but,
this
but,
thing
yeah.
is danger. So
but,
of course you're going to okay. I understand if the child is something of 4th, 5th, or 6th, they are that time. Of course they're still in the playful mood. They won't understand much.
Yeah.
But now okay, you're still from 9th to 12th.
Mm.
Some students, of course, like, they didn't meet their friends for a long time. So of course they are going to come in contact.
Yeah,
with
that's
them.
Exactly what I meant.
Yeah, you said.
See,
I didn't mean like they're stupid kids, dude. I meant like, okay, fine. Like, let's just say a classroom full of 9th standard kids, okay? You know, they have a habit of hitting each other and all that
yeah.
thing as pranks. So I'm saying, in that case, now, like, say in a playful mood, they like want to play a prank on their friends. So they just do like, Jonas!
Yeah,
we've
done that a lot.
we should do it more to Jonas only.
Yeah.
We should bully him a lot.
Actually,
it doesn't mean I have meat all much.
We should bully
Akash
the most.
I'm Siddharth.
Oh yeah.
As a guy who's getting most touched with Joel.
Yeah.
For some, to come back to the coronavirus topic, I was thinking, instead of opening schools, why doesn't the government think a little ahead and say, we'll continue with online classes, but we'll only allow students to come to school and answer exams in batches, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, but that would still, like, you know, like there could be chances that the question papers may be passed around.
No, no. So I mean, you know, each school has enough of classes to accommodate like at least two or three classes with social distancing.
Mm-hmm.
So if a school has, let's say, you can accommodate three classes with social distancing. So if you have three classes of 10th, why not call them and then do their
mm-hmm.
this?
See, we can do one thing, you know, like. They could have, like, I didn't mind them having the exams and all, okay? Like, if you have an online exam, it's okay. But then I think it would be, like, when you see for science students, we have practicals, right? So for that, going to school would be okay because they do
yeah.
call us in batches. And you cannot do practicals online. Like, you can't just, I don't know, catch a laptop and put all
yeah,
kinds of
no,
acid on
I
it and all.
Mean.
So it's better you... Like, if you want to call the students to the school, you call them for practicals, not for exams.
I don't think opening school.
See, I was saying practicals, okay, for science students. If you meant for science students, like, of course, like, some practicals, you have to, like, present them and show.
Yeah.
If you're meaning that, then I feel like, okay, that.
Yeah,
okay.
I don't think opening schools is going to be another good idea. I think it's going to be
yeah, I feel like
opening
we should
again.
Actually open schools at all.
Hmm. Keep it closed
yeah.
for at least a
let
year.
Us wait for some time. Let it get
you, no,
finished.
Not wait for some time. You've got to wait till you get a vaccine or till the coronavirus isn't showing up anymore.
Yeah. That's
yeah,
going to be, that's going to take time though. That's going to be like next.
You know, really people like coming to me and say like, I'm waiting for 2021. Are you waiting for 2021? Like, is it like the corona? Is it like some expiry date it has? Like, okay, 2020, like 2021.
I saw that tweet, yeah.
I'm like, bro, come on, seriously.
Yeah. But you know, like, we have a lot of prizes waiting for us the moment COVID goes away. Like, all the films which got postponed, like Black Widow got postponed, right? So, like, just consider that as your prize and stay at home. Just
but
do that.
If I feel these cases still go on, they might shift like to Netflix and Amazon Prime, like the other platforms.
Yeah, that's there. But like,
yeah,
you
I
know, like, it's like a different, what do you call that, feeling
vibe.
When you go to the movie theater.
Yeah,
different
yeah,
vibe.
Right, yeah, right.
Like a very different vibe.
Yeah.
Especially when you go with your friends over there.
Yeah.
And if they are movie spoilers, it's worse.
And they contribute to popcorn and...
yeah. And then one of the people get looted as usual. By my stupid fucking...
As we're talking about the government issue, I must say, like, first, like, no hate, like, to anyone. We just, see, look, our podcast,
this
of
is
course,
our
we have
our personal opinion.
We,
in our
we are going to speak
yeah.
what's right,
yeah.
what we feel like, what's wrong.
No, also, this is our personal opinion.
Yeah.
We don't want anyone messaging us directly or anyone spreading hate.
See, if you have something, like...
What Joel means is don't, like, send him death threats.
Hate. Case and file an FIR against me, ordering me to come to jail.
Yeah, yeah.
If you all have something like on the video, like how you're going on, just, you know, there's a comment section down. Just comment it down, please.
Yeah, tell us how much you hate Jonas in the comments.
Yeah, Chris, you know, crispy.
Anyway,
so anyways, back to the thing of ours, the issue thing. So. As you were telling me, Joel, like, you wanted to say something about the border
yeah, so
thing.
What I was going to say is, we all know that opening the borders was a bad idea. But what our Goa government didn't do, like Italy, was the follow-up action. If you see Italy, it got hit much worse than
yeah.
in
yeah.
Goa or India combined. But their follow-up action was so good that it was able to not eradicate, but control the virus within a couple of 3 months, which is still not.
You know,
happened.
No. One thing what I liked about Italy, their was that the chief was chief, the mayor.
Yeah, yeah.
Then afterwards, I don't know what they have. Their CM, what?
They have a president.
No, the state who.
Just the government.
Okay, yeah, the government.
Yeah.
The best thing, like they didn't like go like, please go stay at your home. Don't come out. They were like, they were literally firing bad words to the people. Like, yeah, don't come out to this. Go home, people. You know, literally.
I mean,
yeah.
Beep, beep, beep.
Yeah, I mean, if you see, like you said, if the government is so, it doesn't,
strict.
Yeah, if it's so strict, then obviously the people are going to listen. But if you make the people, like if you're not so strict and you make the police roam around the streets and if you find anyone outside and you make them do 10 sit-ups, I don't think anyone is going to take you seriously.
The sit-ups thing was stupid, and also making them roll on the ground was even more stupid.
They should do,
I've seen
sit-ups and afterwards they are
roll on the ground.
What's the thing, Hindu?
Aarti?
Aarti, yesterday Aarti also.
I don't know, but I have seen so many videos of police personnel taking a stick, having a stick in their hand, but looking at the person doing sit-ups.
They should actually insult them, like actually in front of the judge. But I don't like, it's like kind of something foolish.
I don't think it worked though.
People still roamed outside.
Actually,
it became a
talking about now, you know, one issue which I pointed a lot. Okay, see, now certain people, they come, they meet, okay, they have their jobs, or they have some meeting, like, meet up. Okay, I understand that. I won't say to the rest of the people, like, why are you simply coming out, you know?
Yeah.
What if you have a case, if you have affected, or if you are not affected, you're simply, like, putting your life in danger. And imagine the people, like, you know, who are at home, like, the especially the old people, I'll say, like, you know, if in case you have grandparents or something, their lives are actually more in danger.
Yeah.
So actually I prefer, like, you know, if they stayed at home. You understand the people, like, okay, they are working. Literally, most of the time, like, come out, I just see, like, the same people, like, you know, literally roaming, like, every day for no reason. I don't want to say sometimes to them, you know. You can't actually even say anything to them.
You can't say anything because when the government implemented the stay at home, there was no action against the people who were not staying at home.
Yeah.
Like if you see, I don't want to go too much into this, but there was a case filed against one of our friends, Angio Fernandez, for discriminating or making memes on Hindu religion.
Mm.
And he actually went to jail.
Yeah.
That is not as big as an offense as you coming out during coronavirus when the government, the head authority of your country, has initiated a lockdown.
Yeah.
And when the head authority of the country initiates a lockdown and you roam out, you're made to do sit-ups. But if a guy makes a meme on a religion, which I know is bad, I'm not saying it's not, and he got what he deserves, he's going to jail and you're making people do sit-ups, you see the seriousness of the situation.
Yeah, you're right.
And then
that's
you
correct.
And then you start to act.
Yes.
So if your actions and what your follow-up actions aren't serious, why will people take you seriously?
Yeah, that's the point. It's the main point, you know, actually.
Yeah,
you get
see,
up.
Giving the example of the religion thing, memes, I don't think anyone else is going to make memes on religion ever again because they know what will happen if they do it.
Yeah.
You will go to jail and people will come after you.
Mm.
But if you are made to do sit-ups and if you are pretty fit, I think you can roam around outside the house 10 times a day and you can do 100 sit-ups and nothing will happen to you.
Yeah, that's that.
See?
That was a pretty stupid move by the government though. Like you tell the policeman to, like, oh, if people are roaming outside, just make them do sit-ups or roll on the ground and stuff. They won't come out. I'm like, no, that's not gonna happen, dude.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, like, there's no fine also. I don't think so. Were they fining people
what
at that
kind
time?
Of fining, man, bro. Like, literally, the girl is looting people these days. I feel like in my way, you know.
Yeah. It does feel like that.
Because there are many people, like, you know, who are jobless.
Hmm.
Especially, like, you know, like, I have my own business. People, like, they come, literally, like,
yeah,
talking
about
jobs. I mean, you know, it's very hard, like, you know, to give a person a job because, you don't know. Now, suddenly, all of a sudden, a new lockdown comes out.
It's not
what do you have to
the,
pay? What do you have the people
exactly,
to pay who works
economy,
for you?
Economy of our country being in such a bad state that there's no money coming in.
Mm.
So businesses don't have money to pay the staff. And because they don't have money to pay the staff, they have to downsize or they have to lay off people.
Yeah.
Have you seen written people in USA, okay, people in US and other countries? You know how people have lost their jobs?
I know. There's a lot of job loss over there. People are, like, you know, signing
and
up for
especially
those.
Like, you know, one day I don't feel like, you know, I'm not going to say, like, I'm not going to talk with most other country.
Mm.
Like, you see, I'm Goa, the, like, many immigrants are there who come. Have you seen on that day when the government allowed them to go back to the villages?
Yes, I did.
Back? Have you seen the trail? Like, how many the number of people were there? Like, can you imagine? Like, you still know how Goa was first. I would say Goa actually was really a good country. I mean, not country, state. Mistake, I'm sorry. I'm saying country.
Goa is my country. All Goans are my brothers and sisters.
Yes. I wish to go on a separate country.
Yeah, actually that would be a much better thing.
We say that with a cross on our hands.
Yeah, we say that with a cross on our hands.
So talking about that, okay, coming back to the main subject. The immigrants, the number of immigrants have come, like I feel like they have destroyed, you know, Goa. Literally they have destroyed.
It's not only the immigrants that have come into Goa, I think.
See, I'm not blaming them only. It's
I know,
okay,
I
it's
know.
Even our fault.
I know.
Even we have done many shit, like a lot.
Yeah, but it's also, you see, you have to look at why the immigrants are coming into Goa. And it's because the Goans are going out of Goa.
Yeah, that's that.
Goa is not for Goans anymore.
Yeah, I know, you're right.
It's,
point
all,
right.
It's only for outsiders, if I have to say.
Yeah. If you actually see the ratio in your own class,
yeah,
like
oh,
of the Goans and outsiders, there are so many more outsiders than the Goans.
I would say about that.
It's like nowadays when I hear somebody speak Konkani, I'm like, Goaikar mare? Like that.
Talking about cases and all this, I just hope I call for stay home. Like,
yeah,
do
stay
what?
Safe.
Stay home, stay
but
safe.
But one thing I'm happy, like many of them, like, you know, came out of their own businesses, right? You know.
Yeah.
Like homemade, like show like their own talents. That was like one of the great things what they did.
I mean, it's not
show
like
something.
Our podcast, but many
yeah.
people have started doing baking or cooking and you know,
yeah.
they
hats
are,
off to them,
their own
like,
thing.
Whatever. I really like press all these people.
Yeah.
So keep doing that thing.
I mean,
like if you are baking at home, keep baking. Learn new dishes, learn something new. Use this time to, you know, enhance your skills at like. Whatever you are good at. If you're good at singing, sing. If you're good at music, do music. Just do something. Don't waste this.
Be productive. I mean, you won't get this much of free time. Even
ever.
If you, you're
let's hope getting. We don't get this much free time. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, thank you guys for watching.
So, thank you guys for watching.
You're repeating the same thing I'm
I know.
Saying. Dumbass.
It was meant to do it.
Stay safe. Stay at home.
Wear your
mask.
Yeah, mine's the, over there, fine, never mind.
Your mask,
and don't be like us, idiots, do social distancing.
It's of course, we take a precaution
when
we're coming, okay? So
we get sanitizers
yeah,
and everything,
yeah.
okay?
Yeah, we spray our whole bodies with the sanitizer.
So okay, again guys, thank you for watching. I hope you hit the subscribe button, like the video, share the video, and
yeah.
please, comment
yeah.
down
and hit
what
the subscribe button. Hit it. There are like two. There are like 200 people watching our podcast
yeah.
and 60 subscribers. What the hell? See, think that this is the subscribe button and hit it like this, like this. Just hit the subscribe button.
Should we hit him? Should we hit
no
him?
Wait. Hit his face and put the subscribe button and just
yeah.
hit it.
Yeah.
Let's wait. Wait. It is the like button. It's blue, right?
Like the like button, guys.
Hey, the like
okay,
button.
Okay, bye, guys.
The like button
means
gray first.
And see you all next time, the next episode.
See you guys. Take care.
Peace.